Western Australia's central wheat belt, and paddocks of new season wheat are emerging, along with the hopes of another bumper season. But a closer look reveals the season might be bumpy more than a bumper. Yellowing of older leaves and a lighter green colour in the canopy are signs of nitrogen deficiency.
So N deficiency can have a major impact on yields, particularly if it's prior to tillering and you start dropping tillers.
Understanding what to do about it means understanding what's happened and why.
Well, we had big crops in the later year, 2013, meaning they took off more soil nitrogen than was usual. Then that lack of summer rainfall towards the end of 2013 and the start of 2014 meant that it really wasn't that plant available N at the start of the season.
But before growers apply nitrogen to their crops, there's key information they should consider.
The way to determine if you need that application is to figure out, one, if it's to maintain yield potential or if you're trying to target an increase in grain protein.
DEFWA's focus on nitrogen requirements is part of an Australia-wide GRDC-supported project, More Profit from Crop Nutrition, an initiative to help growers achieve better returns from fertiliser expenditure.
Well, as a rule of thumb, the later the application, the less likelihood of a profitable response to nitrogen, but it depends where you are on that response curve. You can get an indication of that from a tissue test.
Nitrogen response late in the season is variable and depends on getting enough rain to keep soil moist enough for the crop to take up the applied N, which is why growers are urged to gather good information before applying nitrogen as the season progresses.
There's no clear reason for growers to go out and get very trigger happy about nitrogen applications. The best thing to do is to go back and revise your N budget, see where the season's heading, tissue test to make sure you're in the ballpark for a particular part of the season, and use all that information together to try and make the best decision you can.
And for more information on tissue testing and maximising nitrogen availability, go to the following links.